Hi, I'm Brian Chen. I've just picked up a Lehigh motion controller, which I'm really excited to use as part of my research. I'm interested in using it to try to design structural bioinformatics software that will be more accessible for biologists who might be interested in using computational tools, but might not have the Unix background in order to use a lot of those devices. So I'm just going to give you a quick demo of what this is capable of and how I'd like to use it. So the Lehigh motion controller is just this little stick here. It looks kind of like a USB drive. And what it does is it uses an infrared camera to detect where my hands are. And so what you see up here on the screen is just a space where there's a bunch of particles. And the Lehigh motion controller is detecting the location of my fingers. And it lets me sort of point to things. And it lets me use the location of my hand to tell the computer facts, like if I want to point to something or if I want to move something. It's got a lot of potential as a sensing and gestural device. So the great thing about this device is that it's very fast, and it's very accurate, and it's also very cheap. So that means that it's something that people could use in different software and sciences to manipulate complicated objects and just communicate with the computer in a different way. And right now, it's not specialized for scientific software. It has a lot of potential, but we haven't developed any software for it. In fact, it was just released about a week ago, and we're just getting our chance to play with it now. So what I'm doing here is I'm just showing you how it can detect different hands and fingers on the using the device. And the sort of thing that I'd like to use this device for is to interact with molecular viewers like this one. So this is PyMol. It's a classic molecular viewer used by many structural biologists. And what it does is it lets them get an idea of the shape of a protein. So what you see here is trypsin. Trypsin is a digestive protein that it's used in just essentially breaking down food proteins that you consume in your stomach. And it would be really great if we could interact with trypsin in a more tactile way by essentially not just rotating and translating it with our hands with gestures, but actually using our hands to select individual amino acids and individual atoms. You can imagine here that because you're seeing all these individual atoms here, clicking on any specific atom would actually be pretty hard. They cover each other up and they hide behind each other. And just getting a better way to interact with these atoms and being able to address the ones I want to work with and produce analyses of these atoms on the fly would be something that would really help people perform analyses and connect the field of computer science more with structural biology. So that's something I'm interested in doing, and that's something that I see as possible in the future.